BJP has gained big in the Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation poll. Springing a surprise, the BJP emerged as the second largest party, pushing its tally from just 4 seats in 2016 to 48 this time. While BJP expanded its presence, TRS received a big jolt. It ended up as the largest party, but came down from 99 wards in 2016 to just 55 now. AIMIM, on the other hand, managed to win all the old seats, ending with 44 seats in its kitty. Congress, with 2 seats, witnessed another poll debacle. Its state unit chief, Uttam Kumar Reddy, resigned, taking responsibility for the loss. Buoyed by the results, BJP President JP Nadda congratulated BJP Telangana team and also thanked the people of Hyderabad. He also said that BJP will now win the upcoming assembly polls in West Bengal and also the Telangana assembly polls, which is scheduled to happen in 2023. Expressing surprise over the results, Telangana Minister KT Rama Rao, KCR's son, said that he expected TRS to win around 25 more seats.
ग्रेटर हैदराबाद म्यूनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन के चुनाव के नतीजे आए हैं, वह एक बात स्पष्ट करते हैं कि हैदराबाद की जनता ने भी आदरणीय नरेंद्र मोदी जी, भारत के प्रधानमंत्री जी की विकास यात्रा पर मुहर लगाई है। मैं हैदराबाद की जनता का धन्यवाद देता हूं, मैं उसके साथ साथ हैदराबाद की जनता के साथ साथ हमारे तेलंगाना और हैदराबाद के कार्यकर्ताओं को बधाई देता हूँ कि उन्होंने अथक प्रयास करके एक शानदार नतीजे, एक शानदार रिजल्ट भारतीय जनता पार्टी के पक्ष में लाए हैं।
हैदराबाद में सभी जिला के लोग रहते हैं, सभी प्रांतों के लोग रहते हैं। जो जजमेंट है वो तेलंगाना में पूरा प्रभाव होगा। भारतीय जनता पार्टी के लिए आने वाले दिन में एक ठीक एक रास्ता सरकार माने के लिए आज का वोटिंग के सिस्टम से, आज का रिजल्ट के सिस्टम से जनता बता दिया है।
It's certainly short of about 20-25 seats. The fact is, we lost about 10-12 divisions with an extremely narrow margin of 100 or 200 or less than 200 votes. In fact, a couple of divisions like the BN Reddy Nagar and Malkajgiri, where we lost by 18 votes and 70 votes, are classic examples of that, as to how narrow the margin of defeat or victory was. I thank every single TRS party.
We were able to retain the 44 municipal wards out of the 51 we had contested. And this is the highest strike rate of a political party in the Hyderabad Parliament constituency, which also includes the heart of Hyderabad, jisko hum bolte dhadakta hua dil of Hyderabad, where BJP said we'll do a surgical strike. The people of Old City have done a democratic strike on the BJP and Sangh Parivar.
Let me take this across to Ashish Pandey, who's getting us the latest updates from Hyderabad. Ashish, tell us really what the mood in Hyderabad is right now after these results. Is there a sense that, you know, the TRS could have fared better but failed because of the BJP's massive aggressive campaign?
Yes, Akshita, you are absolutely right. If we see the way BJP campaigned, it was just 9-day long campaign. BJP started this campaign on 21st. And then the campaign was ended on 29th of November. So it was just 9-day long campaign, but BJP's top leadership, including National President JP Nadda, Union Home Minister Amit Shah, UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, former Maharashtra Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis, all coming here, all campaigning for the party in this municipal election. It's clearly show the way BJP put its effort to secure victory in Greater Hyderabad.
Apologies, we seem to have lost a connection with Ashish, but let me just get you all of the highlights from the GHMC poll results yesterday. This is very, very crucial for the BJP because it aims to expand really its political footprint in the south. The party now has its eyes set on the Kerala local body poll scheduled later this month, as well as the 2021 Tamil Nadu assembly elections.
It may have been just a municipal poll, but one with larger implications. The Hyderabad civic polls were fought fiercely, with BJP big guns entering the poll battlefield. And the results have brought BJP a reason to cheer. While the TRS remains the largest party, the BJP has succeeded in making significant gains, pushing its tally from just 4 in the last civic polls to more than 30 seats this time.
The BJP went with a twin strategy with senior leaders like Yogi Adityanath, Tejasvi Surya attacking Asutri Uvesi, while JP Nadda and others kept the attack on the TRS. These celebrations are an indication of how the BJP is now going to inroads further into Telangana and would ensure that they emerge as a tough opponent.
The Hyderabad civic polls were being seen as a crucial preparation ground for the 2023 Telangana Assembly elections. The BJP's impressive gains will give the party the confidence to replace Congress as the principal challenger to TRS in the state.
Congress is a dead horse and it's gone. We are the only alternative to TRS now in the state, and we are the primary opposition. We were number 3, now we are number 2. And it will not be too far when we will be number 1.
The BJP has been pushing hard to make inroads in southern states where regional parties remain dominant players. The party has now eyes set on the Kerala local body polls, where in a bid to reach out to minorities, it has fielded 112 Muslim and 500 Christian candidates. Not just in Hyderabad, top BJP leaders are inviting other southern states to shore up support for the party. Home Minister Amit Shah recently visited Chennai 6 months ahead of Tamil Nadu assembly polls. But the question is, will a decent show in civic polls translate into victory in bigger polls? Bureau Report, India Today.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.